And you mentioned that it may be difficult to reinvent the United Nations. If it didn't exist, what would we do? Well, in a sense, we're from as many people as possible what their thoughts are about how to shape the future of the United Nations regime exists. As we all know, the United Nations needs to look like, if it is going to be effective into the future, an international center, some students from the regional academy of the United Nations are taking part in just such a discussion. And there are other students, high school students, university students, taking part in model United Nations events there at the Vienna International Center this week, also having those conversations. And it's all very well to talk about it,
but on peace and security and development. With that in mind, we expect to hear a lot from him and from us generally in the year in 2020 and beyond. And he's, you've probably seen, he's already been very active in the media and public arena at large. For an Austrian audience, he did a big interview with the Standard.
But the industry development in the UN context, and I say this in the UN context because we know that many people think that economy is run by businesses and that's pretty much it. Reality is, we see it is not as simple as we want to see this. So without economic growth, we know that many of the SDGs...
The United Nations in 75 years, the great achievements. The growth of the United Nations from 50 countries to 193 countries. But it's also really important that we start to look ahead to shape the future of the United Nations, particularly for young people. So those are the two big priorities that we have, and I think the central plan there is very much to bring young people together, to motivate them to work with the United Nations and to take action themselves to help to change the world through the sustainable development goals. Yeah. When it comes to coordinating with journalists, today's event here, press briefing, of course, that's an annual event, but our work with journalists goes on throughout the year, and different bits of the UN family are based in Vienna, whether it's the Division of Atomic Energy Agency, the UN Office on Drugs and Crime. They have a constant flow of contacts and interaction with journalists.
Consequences, or are there any consequences in terms of posts? I think this is what people are really worried about, and also in terms of programming funding or anything else that might come out of this financial crisis that the UN is currently experiencing.
Okay. Well, obviously, this is a subject of some consternation from the Secretary General down.
Member states, NGOs, institutions, experts looking at the whole issue of the drug problem worldwide, be it the global opioid crisis, the issue of...
So I very much hope that during the course of 2020 we'll be able to announce further signatures and further ratifications. We also just hit a major milestone in building...